Okay, guys, welcome to the last part of my mini-series talking about how to scrap an old derby car. In this video, we're going to talk about a bunch of smaller parts inside of the derby car that I think are worth keeping. A lot of you guys probably wouldn't bother, but if you're cheap like me, everything's worth keeping. Coming into the inside of this car, you'll see it's pretty rusty. It's been sitting outside for 2 years now, not being used. And I have already removed my gas tank, the brackets, my switch box, battery mount, and brackets. I have one more battery mount bracket to go, or more of a brace for it, I suppose. I gotta crawl underneath the car and loosen the nut, remove that. The entire brake pedal and everything has already been removed. Took that when I took the master cylinder of the brakes. Something I recommend keeping out of cars, definitely the seat bar. This will be coming out of this car. There's even a leg mount on that side welded to the floor because the doors were bent so bad I put one in for the last run. And conveniently, because this is an old derby car and you're not trying to keep the car, the easiest way to remove seat bars, you don't have to even cut the seat bar. I'm probably just going to cut part of the metal from the door and pull the whole seat bar out with part of the inner metal of the car still attached to it. Then with it outside of the car, I can clean it up, grind the edges, and turn it back into a normal bracket for the seat bar. That'll work out just fine. If you have a full cage in your car, a little bit trickier. It depends the type of cage you have in your car. A common cage that a lot of people like for easy access and movability is a bolt-in cage. Basically, what that means is every piece of the cage bolts to the other bracket. Less welding is involved, and you can reuse it more. You still do have to weld some stuff of it, obviously, to get it to attach to the car. And hopefully, you know, whenever I finally start making cages with my cars that fit for modified rules, I will experiment with different cage designs, and we can talk about that. For now, this car only had a seat bar. Also recommend, a lot of guys do not keep these items, but body mounts. This car still has the stock factory body mounts. Yes, believe it or not, it does. So there's nothing to see from the inside here. But usually once you replace those body mounts, you will have all thread or bolts going through your frame with washers and nuts. Now, I don't know about you guys, but buying a lot of nuts and washers gets expensive. Especially when you buy them 10 at a time for every car here. So I will remove every body mount possible. My Thunderbird has all new body mounts in it. When I scrap that car, I will keep every body mount out of the frame I can. Maybe keep just a couple to hold the body to the frame on the trailer when I bring it to the junkyard. Other than that, I don't need them. Next thing a lot of people won't think of, but I do recommend keeping at least one extra, is your seatbelt. Normally I scrap these with my cars until I got a car one time that did not have a seatbelt hookup. A friend of ours, actually, his car was like that. There was no seatbelts in it. Somebody had already stripped them out. Well, if you don't have an extra, then what? Then you have to go find one. So if you have a working seatbelt, I recommend unbolting it, keeping it with the car. This one actually works really well with this car, but I don't need to unbolt it and keep it because I have one with my Thunderbird that does unbolt very easy to keep. So this one will stay with the car and get scrapped. Next is the driver's seat, obviously. That's a pretty big item in the car. Since this seat, as you can tell, is destroyed and ripped and not the best shape, I'm not going to bother keeping it. I will plan on keeping a future driver's seat, and I'm going to make a custom bracket on the bottom of it that can be self-adjusted so I can have the seat slid forward or backwards and have it mount in a car. This will make putting seats in derby cars much easier than using the factory four-corner bolts. Also, this car did have a sunroof at one time, and I did remove the big piece of metal we had over the sunroof that was bolted down, I will keep that for future cars in case they ever do have a sunroof. I've had actually three cars now that had sunroofs. The Thunderbird also has a sunroof. Not many people know that. There on top of it is a sheet of metal. I did accidentally leave a fuel pump laying in here. My bad. That fuel pump sat out here for over a year through winter. Not sure if it's still good. I'm going to have to check and see. If water got in there and froze, it might break some pieces. I'll check that out sometime when I wire it to a battery. Also, the very last thing I want to mention. Very, I think, helpful feature and thing to keep is the wiring. If you still have any old wiring left in your cars from running a stock class derby, do not keep them in the car. Go ahead and cut out as much wiring as you can separate from the car and keep that separated. Because wiring is worth copper value, obviously, and you can get a lot more money from it with it outside of the car. They're not going to pay you copper scrap price when you bring an entire car in. So I'm going to follow all this wiring, cut it out of there. Whatever's back here, actually that wiring must go under the seat and further on under this way. There's some computer controls, so I'm going to cut all the wiring off of that. Most of this dashboard already was removed, so I don't have to worry about that. But definitely do that. Any of you bone stock guys, man, I see people scrap bone stock cars after they're done with the derby with all the components still in them. There is a lot of wiring you can take out of those cars, and that is good copper money. Whether you decide, you know, to strip the actual coating off of the wires, burn it, or whatever you choose to do, or you can just scrap them as is with the coating on it, you get more, obviously, for the bare copper. So, definitely taking that out of the car. Now, I'm pretty sure that covers everything of importance or value from inside the derby car that you would want to keep. If you guys think of anything else, feel free to leave a comment under the video. Anything you think I should keep out of this car from the inside. Or if there's anything you guys keep different that I don't, let me know. If you want to see how bad the floor is, check this out. Well, I can actually get the carpet up. Much junk in here. Yeah, not much floor left inside this car. Right there's the actual cross member. If I didn't mention it, you do want to keep the cross members out of cars. I will be keeping it out of this car. I haven't got around to it yet. I'm actually just going to cut it off, leaving part of it still attached on the frame on both sides. I'm going to reinforce the edges of the cross member with metal, make a new mounting hole because these are rusty. So that will get cut off with a cutting wheel for too long. But yeah, there's my nice floorboard for the driver's feet of this car. When I first bought this car, that floor actually only had a small hole. It progressively grew larger every time I ran it in a derby, until one derby my feet actually went through the floor. After that, we just threw a car mat in here, self-tapped it to the floor, and well, there you go. Rust protection for your feet. Cheap and easy. That's pretty much the ending to my mini-series talking about how to scrap old derby cars. There is a lot of useful things you can keep off of every car. Once you have enough extra parts saved up, though, it's really not worth keeping them. I mean, if you have 10 extra A-arms and steering boxes laying around, you probably don't need to keep them off any more cars until you start using those up. But for me, I have nothing extra yet, so I will go ahead and keep what I can and start making a stockpile. I hope this video is useful to some people that are just starting out with derbies. and hopefully taught you guys a few things to keep off of your cars. Until the next video, guys, this is Demolition Missions, signing out.